गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. द बैच फिफ्थ बैच ऑफ पीजीपी एंड द थर्ड बैच ऑफ फेल प्रोग्राम इन मैनेजमेंट. वेलकम टू आई एम रायपुर. ऑल द डिस्टिंग्विश्ड पर्सन्स ऑन द डायस, श्री केवल हंडा, प्रोफेसर सहाय, प्रोफेसर विनीता सहाय, प्रोफेसर प्रद्युम्न दास एंड प्रोफेसर पी आर सर, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू. आई एम गोइंग थ्रू द प्रोफाइल ऑफ पर्सन्स हू हैव जॉइंड हियर टुडे एंड आई फाइंड दैट इन द स्टेट वाइज डाइवर्सिफिकेशन ओनली 5 पीपल आर फ्रॉम छत्तीसगढ़. दैट मीन्स रिमेनिंग 170 आर फ्रॉम आउटसाइड द स्टेट. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव ट्रैवल्ड बाय ट्रेन फॉर कमिंग हियर? Okay, so I see a large number of people who have used your vehicle. How many of you have traveled in sleeper class by coming to this place?
That's nice.
I know you came by the morning flight, sir. So I know I'm talking to the people who are a customer of Indian Railways. First of all, my heartiest congratulations to all of you for getting the admission into the prestigious Indian Institute of Management, Raipur. I belong to an organization which is known as Indian Railways, which is only about 160 years old. I am indeed very privileged and honored to be serving this wonderful organization. I'm sure you must have heard something about it. It is the second largest railways in the world under a single management. But probably there are certain other things also. Indian Railways will probably come number one on the list of caterers. We are serving close to 1 million meals per day. We would also be counted amongst the topmost linen suppliers. It is about 3 lakhs linen per day. It's, the idea is not to give you some mind-boggling statistics, but only to say that railways is not only about running some coaches and engine on the railway tracks. It is much more complex than what appears from outside. I'll just like to give you some brief historical background. In some form or the other, the railway started in the 6th BC, 6th century BC that is. And through various innovations all through years, it was somewhere around 1830 that what we normally know as the start of the railway age, when the railway started in England. It came to India very early. If 1830 was the first train which ran in England, it was on 16th April 1853 that India, the Indian continent, had the privilege of running the first train on 16th April 1853 from Boribandar, what was then known as Victoria Terminus and now known as Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus in Bombay, to a distance 34 kilometers away at Thane. Friends, railways have made a tremendous impact on the way this country lives or breathes. I was posted in Bombay when the 150th year celebrations took place. How many of you are from Bombay? Okay. So I know, I hope you are fully aware of the impact which the suburban railways makes on Bombay. We had a rerun of that first train which ran in 1853. We started from Bombay Windy at exactly the same time at 3:35 PM and travelled to Thane. It was run by a steam locomotive. Again, the steam locomotives we have stopped operating for almost 25-30 years, we were able to again revive one steam locomotive, and along with it attach some of the latest coaches which were there. We had a lot of coupling problems and all that, but still we ran that. And believe me, I was on that train. The whole city of Bombay was lined up on both sides of the track. It was really a sight which, even after a decade, I have yet to forget. The response the entire city of Bombay gave to the railways is tremendous. If you go into the origins, some of the management words which have been talked about, like FDI, like PPP, these are already part and parcel of the origins of Indian Railways. It was conceived, the whole Indian Railways project was conceived as a colonial project of the British on commercial terms. But in 1857, when the mutiny took place, or what we refer to as the first fight of independence took place, after that the Britishers realized that railways cannot be only run on the commercial term, but it has to be available to us for strategic term, for movement of troops. And that is when they encouraged a lot of private companies to come into it. By about 1859, 7 private railway companies had been formed with a mandate to construct 5,000 miles of lines, and they were assured a minimum return of 4.5 to 5% of the return on their capital, and in case there was some surplus over and above, then that was to be shared 50% by the government and 50% among the shareholders. So, gentlemen, I belong to the organization which started this all, what we are talking about today. When I talk of the new technologies being used, the first computers on Indian Railways were purchased in 1960s, when nobody else in the country was using computers. I was seeing your age profile. Probably all of you were born when you have already seen the passenger reservation systems, the computerized ones. This started in the year 1985. Prior to that, the reservations were done through manual registers on individual stations, and you had to queue up only on that one particular counter to get your reservations done. Of course, now we know, and again, I am very proud to be part of this wonderful team. This software application of the passenger reservation system of Indian Railways is again one of the best software in the world, and it has been developed all in-house earlier by a company known as Computer Maintenance Corporation, or CMC, and now by one of the railway PSUs only. The railways, as we all know, is running 24 hours, 7 days, 365 days a year. What does it signify in a single this thing? The main point which I would just like to emphasize is the teamwork. Probably most of the people who travel on the trains, for them the railways would mean a driver, a guard, a TT on the train, and a station master. Probably these are the 4 images which people would be having. But these are only the front end. Behind the scenes, we have got the technical departments, the civil engineering department, which broadly I will say is looking after the tracks which are laid, the mechanical and the electrical departments which are working the maintaining the coaches and the engines, the signaling department which are working all the signals through which on the trains run. one of the major differences between the railway operation and the road operation, which most of you are all aware, the railway operates on a single dimension. Since most of you are engineers, I'm sure you all know what is 1D, 2D and 3D. So this operates on a single line. It does not have a steering wheel. The signals which are given to them is not for a bunch of 100 trains which go at a time, as we see on the traffic, road traffic. One signal is only for one train. And the direction which it will take is not decided by the driver sitting on the locomotive, but by the controller, who is controlling a distance of about 150 or 200 kilometers. The idea what I'm trying to say is that kindly do not be swayed by the songs which you see on the movie screen, a hero and a heroine dancing around it, and that they are the only things which are made of the movie. Since you are going to be the leaders, what you have to appreciate is that that is only the front portion which is being seen by you. All the hard work which goes is behind the scenes, and that as a leader is one of the main things which you will always have to see. You have already seen Cristiano Ronaldo is one of the best players in the world, but single Cristiano Ronaldo cannot make his team go to the second round. It is the team which has to work in a proper procedure. This is the basic point which I would like to say. Your director just now mentioned about the skill, the speed and the scale. Now this is something which is such a wonderful thing to get from your first guru here. Unless until we dream big, obviously the net output which we are going to produce is going to be much smaller. So dream big, and I'll just like to narrate two, three things which convey the spirit of the whole organization. I'm sure since most of you have traveled on the railways, you would be feeling there are a lot of ills. Yes, we are a government sector, and maybe not fully 100% efficient, which you would expect a private corporate to be. But I am very proud to say that it is in the DNA of the blood of each and every railwayman to run the trains without any delay. I have seen occasions when I was posted at Varanasi. Incidentally, the railways have given me the opportunity of working throughout the length and breadth of the country, from Bombay to Calcutta, from Delhi to Karnataka. It was in UP that between two gangs there was some massive massacre which had taken place one afternoon, and it was all known that the next day is going to be very, very hard, and lot of arson and things like that are going to happen. We were sitting in the control room monitoring the situation, and when all the other government departments had left their posts, we were trying to contact the civil administration and police and all that. There was no response. We were continuously getting the report from my station master at the station without any security that okay, now the mob is about a kilometer away, 500 meters and all that. And when they were really very close, that was the time when they told us, sir, now we are leaving the station because now it is absolutely unsafe. At various and after that the station was burned. After that, the speed at which the entire team worked to restore the train traffic was something which I am really very proud. We are all very fond of abusing the public sector. 4-5 years back, when there was a big cloudburst in Bombay, the entire city had come to a grinding halt. And at that time, if you could remember, all the employees of the private electricity company had fled away, and there was nobody to even start working the work, the restoration work. And it was only the public sector people who were doing it. The point what I am trying to say is, kindly do not get into one mindset that it is only the efficient corporate sector which is everything. I agree. I mean, one of the oft-repeated sentences are, government has no business to be in the business. I agree. Yes, it should not get into the business part. But still, one fact remains that you cannot do away with this concept entirely. When I am dealing with my clientele, bulk of it is those who do not travel in the reserved compartments. When I was in Bombay, at that time, lot of people during the summer rush come towards East UP and Bihar. They are all unreserved people, nothing. We were running special trains for them to come. Even the task of selling tickets was becoming so difficult because of the large crowd which I'm attached. Now there also we kept on making small innovations rather than the train coming and becoming a free for all to enter the coaches. On the platform, we made through the bamboo barricades a long queue, serpentine queue, and there people would come almost 8 to 10 hours before the departure of the train. Now, during the summer time, it is very difficult for them to be kept at a one place. People have to go for attending call of nature, they need water, food and all that. And that is what we kept on attempting and doing it. So basically what I am trying to say here is that whatever you do, after you cannot be omnipresent. You can only be as good as the system which you make and then try to see that the system is being implemented. Friends, now at the end I'll just like to share some points which you as youngsters should always follow. The fact that you are here means you are intelligent, you are hardworking and you are ambitious. So this is a given. I'm not deliberating into those points at all. One of the first points is, though I am very poor at it, is proper time management. You have to be very ruthless with time. If you read those 7 Habits book of Stephen Covey, this is one of those things where you divide all your activities into important and non-important and urgent and not urgent, and see you only operate in one quadrant so that you do not get dragged to the urgent and not important quadrant early. The second thing is, the fact that you are all here means you are already, God has bestowed you with good luck. Be always thankful to God for all the small mercies which He has given us. We are all very fortunate. Kindly never use any statement like it, ki meri to kismat kharab hai. Everybody in life goes through ups and downs. This is all part of life. And this is what is the major challenge that you have to overcome those. Next is, kindly spend quality time with your friends and family. You can always be replaced by your employer, but you can never be replaced in your family. There is no point getting irritated at the end of your career that, oh, I did not spend some quality time with my wife and my children and all that. This is something which is very, very important. Spend quality time with your family. Have holidays. In our speed for towards career building, we often ignore our health. And one of the major problems right now, what has happened is, all day long, All the younger generation is only working on laptops and computers, which is in any case injurious to your spinal cord. If you do not enjoy good health, everything in life is all secondary and useless. So kindly take very good care of your health, because that is something which you cannot buy. And finally, kindly do not let the child in you die. At each and every occasion, take full enjoyment of whatever is the spirit. There is nothing like that. This will be a major point at which I will celebrate and enjoy. Life is a celebration. Each and every minute of it is a celebration. Kindly enjoy it to the hilt. And once again, congratulations and all the best for your stay at IIM Raipur and your career. Thank you.